This French atheist said, "Cruelty is simply the energy in a man civilization has not yet altogether corrupted. Therefore, it is a virtue, not a vice." Look what I just pulled out of my ass. Self-righteous opinion on abortion. Self-righteous opinion on homosexuality. Self-righteous opinion on when the legal drunk age should be. Self-righteous opinion on suicide. Self-righteous opinion on adultery's legality. Self-righteous opinion on veganism, whether it's right or wrong to eat meat. That's cherry-picking. Pick your poison. Mark Twain, an atheist, said, "Too much of anything is bad, but too much good whiskey is barely enough." So he cherry-picked alcohol addiction to be a virtue, not a vice, even though it is a vice. The bar for meeting the typical atheist standard is this high. Drunkenness is not a crime to liberal atheist countries. God won't judge by your piss-poor low standards. Move out the way, an atheist's ethics coming through. Disclaimer, yes, many religious people are drunkards, such as my heretic big sister, whom I used to hear vomiting. But the Bible is against that, so those are irrelevant here. She was a liberal, corrupted by the materialistic United States of America with its low atheist standards. She wanted to fit in so much she degenerated. The U.S. of AIDS is secular, a euphemism for atheistic. So the religious drunkards you find are drunkards because the atheistic paradigm prevails in their society, not a religious and ultra-conservative view. Even if you are an atheist against drunkenness being legal, that doesn't mean your system is entirely good. That you are an atheist means you are an ingrate. Ingratitude is, by a high standard, selfish, evil. The only way for morality to be objective is for the creator of reality to make it reality. Atheism is denial of such, so every atheist, by their own paradigm, is akin to one saying, "Vanilla is the best flavor, or you should be imprisoned." Now, fake Christians, also known as heretics, are afraid to cover politically incorrect parts of the Bible, but I don't cherry-pick. Here is a tweet of Richard Dawkins, an atheist preacher, saying 60% of Moroccan men said, "If a woman is raped, she should marry her rapist," which he finds to be horrific. I'll get to the Bible section matching that Moroccan view, but first, look at this. Twitter's logo has 666. More evidence for the Bible, which says Satan rules Earth for now. And here's another example. So Deuteronomy says, if a man is caught in the act of raping a young woman who is not engaged, he must pay some shekels to her father, and then he must marry that woman because he raped her, and he will never be allowed to divorce her. Atheists who cite this as supposed proof that the Bible is evil are bigots imposing their subjective, self-righteous, arbitrary, politically correct, subject to change, expiration date having, opinions of right and wrong, as if they matter. Atheists do this in sheer hypocrisy, since atheism justifies all evil, and I'm not exaggerating, by the nature made me do it implication. If we are just puppets of nature, then choice does not exist, and neither would guilt. Atheism implies we are just natural things, because if we are spirits, we come from a great spirit, at least one, which means a god. Atheism doesn't allow that. Atheism is denial of that. It is lack of belief in that. So it implies that maybe we are just physical things. Maybe we're just puppets of nature, in which case nature made me do it, and choice is an illusion, and guilt doesn't exist. And therefore, all evil is justified by atheism. So every time an atheist judges someone as evil, they are showing that they don't really believe in materialism, that only matter exists, since if they did, they would never blame someone for what nature made them do. An atheist consistent with atheism, materialism, would bash his head on a keyboard to type stuff because intelligence isn't necessary. They also would never condone of any type of punishment on criminals. So having said that, let's look at the evil passage. But unlike atheists, let us take context into account. In ancient Israel, if a woman is not a virgin, no man will want to marry her, with very few exceptions, because virginity was treasured. Though your corrupt society tells you to have no commitment in marriage, like dogs. If the rapist were not forced to have to provide for her, she would likely never have a provider once her father died, unless a relative would have taken her as their burden. But the Bible says the guilty one should have to bear that burden, which is just. So let's compare my religion with atheism on this issue. Christianity says, bear the burden of responsibility, rapist, and go to hell if you won't repent with sins paid for by Jesus. But atheism says nature made him rape, so he is innocent, and he should not provide for her. He'll get away with rape when he dies, LMAO. Remember, when you are dead, you do not know you are dead. It is only painful for others. The same applies when you are stupid. Wrong. The mind is free to think. The brain, on the other hand, is a slave to physics. Ergo, the brain is not the mind. So brain death does not equal death of the mind, death of the real you. Look at this stupid atheist propaganda. There's probably no design, no purpose, no evil, no good, nothing but pitiless indifference. Now stop worrying and enjoy your life. We assert no hell after death, so YOLO, live selfishly, LMAO. I'm a Barbie girl. I die soon, so I better YOLO it up. Earlier, he looks smart. He wears glasses. Like, hi. Salutations. By Darwin's beard, she's hot in a figurative sense. Well, hello. Oh no, I have an erection. Like, hi again. What pretext can I use? I know. This isn't what it looks like. I'm a liar. It's not Viagra. You're funny. I'm also rich and notorious. Oh, thank ego, it's receding. Look at those graphics. I'm single, you know. You and me, baby, ain't nothing but mammals, so let's do it like they do in the Discovery Channel. Do you take me for a slut? How do you identify as? On Mondays, I identify as male. On Tuesdays, as random. Wednesdays, I'm a Buddha. Thursdays, Thor's slave. Fridays, I am Mecca's stone. Saturdays, I'm a ranting online atheist, wasting the only life they claim to have, showing how miserable they are inside. Today is Sunday. I'm a feminist activist. Wanna hear me roar? Yeah. Roar! Oh, look at the time. Help me smile at cameras. People flock to me for my nihilism, but your face sells more. I'll give you money and stuff.
Marry me.
Marriage is a vestige of religious patriarchy.
Like, what does that mean?
I'm an enlightened atheist. We are just beasts. No need for love.
What about love of money?
I concede. Oh, no time for chit-chat. My company has arrived. Let us go.
Like, sure. Intellectuals not allowed in Cambodia.
You're all idiots, except me.
North Korea, best Korea.
My universe. Mine, mine, mine. For God is not great. I am. Blah, blah, blah. Is this the face of a man who would lie to you? According to modern science, gray hair makes you wise, and baldness reflects light, so he is ever more brilliant. Unfortunately, he can never achieve Darwin's sage beard. The beard makes the sage, you know, so said Anonymous, a prolific author. British beard versus Spanish beard. Materialism versus Quintilam Dei. Atheists tell me few atheists are in prison, so they are morally superior. In an atheist country with low atheist standards, they are good people. Circular reasoning. They're like a Muslim saying, Muslims keep the law in Saudi Arabia better than atheists, so Muslims are morally superior. Atheists' argument on their demographic being underrepresented in prisons in atheistic countries is as valid as, most in prison are men, so men are morally inferior. That's funny because most atheists are men, or liberals who act effeminately, and therefore I hesitate to call them men. Disclaimer, Republican, I am not. I hate democracy, which is a bandwagon fallacy, or error. If all the atheists and agnostics left the United States of America, they'd lose that much of the National Academy of So-Called Science and less than 1% of the prison population, said Ricky Gervais.
If all of the anti-Juden scientists left Germany, we would have zero scientists, haha,
said Parallel Universe Ricky Gervais. Same logic. The Brits have a thing for Nazis. This atheist clown thinks he's funny, which he is in an unintentional way. Back to antiquity for the next video, God willing. Yeah.